serving.
Cheers.
Spark's not having alcohol.
Yeah. What's up, it's Snow Coast Battles. Representing the Midwest, I'm Dr. Ujizi. With me as always, the Mad Hatter, Anna D'Agostino. Let's get right into it. On my right.
I would be Abstracted. That's my rap name, I suppose. And just gonna be playing a show after this, so everybody stick around and
just hopefully have fun. Everybody have fun.
Fuck that. On my left,
Stoney J. Kool-Aid hit me up. Anybody got a blunt after this? My name is Stoney J. Get me high.
Keep it down, y'all. Respect the MCs here. Let's listen to what they gotta say. You stood on my right, sir. Call it in the air with my big ass quarter.
Heads.
It's heads. Who do you want to go first?
That is a fucking big ass quarter.
Alright. Here we go. We're getting into it.
Alright. Yo, I bet this whack bitch can't go 3 minutes without saying clitoris. And you call yourself a rapper. That's just ridiculous. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, because I've been known to make mistakes. But doesn't it look like an asteroid came in from outer space and smashed directly into his face? I mean, Jesus! It's obvious this kid's on drugs. Just about as obvious that he's on steady peas nuts. Yo, and Andre, you ain't a giant, more like a snaggle-tooth butt pirate. And you're always running your mouth like you provoke violence, but I'm gonna rip your vocal cords out so you remain silent. And Abstract says his raps are urban, so if you're from the city, he'll make y'all clap. And growing up, he was like, Dad, I don't want to wear a turban. I want to wear a baseball cap.
That's pretty good.
And in his spare time, he likes to teach how to spit sentences to the rapping youth. But it's got to feel awfully shitty knowing your only apprentice has always been better than you.
That's a minute on Abstract. Give it up for him, man. Come on.
So what's up, crowd? Let me introduce you to Stoney J, a guy who spends his lonely days on the internet looking for local gays. He's a homeless chase, a kid whose rap style is about as dope as AIDS, and on top of all of that, he's a white boy who doesn't know his race. He's confused. He thought it'd be cool to wear his hat backwards, put on a bag, pull his pants down to a sag, and put on a baggy shirt like that's hood. Your rap should be categorized with retards and degenerates. And I'd flip on the shit that you said last time, except that I don't remember it. Oh, wait. I vaguely recall you said you lost because of this and that. Let me break the news to you, homeboy. You lost because your shit is whack. You've got shitty raps. I'd rather listen to Diddy's crap than listen to another single second of you spitting, Jack. I'm fit with that hip-hop style that people feed on. You're just a girl from an R. Kelly sex tape about to get peed on.
Alright, Abstract has a bad habit, but I'm not talking about drugs. The only time this cat's down to rap is after he's caught a buzz. And I'm sure you thought today'd be an easy W, well I hope you came prepared, cause there's no way I'm going 0-2 against a guy who's probably never grown facial hair. Yo, and this terrorist freak hasn't bathed in weeks, so before you get in my face, go brush your fucking teeth. Abstract says his music's original, but something just isn't clear. How come every track you've dropped sounds exactly like Atmosphere? Yo, and this peasant has a weak presence, turns to razor blades to release tension. When it comes to battling, he's a bit reckless, and he isn't talking jewelry when he says Far Out gave him a pearl necklace. Yo, on some real shit though, you'll probably never be more than an open mic whore, cause being dope without a bottle seems to be a mighty big chore. You're an alcoholic, a topic hard to ignore. You'll probably find this kid at 6 a.m. smashing windows to get in the liquor store. It's hard to have a conversation with this pop princess without Steady P getting mentioned. Well, he's moved on. I thought you would have followed in his footsteps.
Damn. Got me good. Got me good. Holy shit.
Andre.
Oh, actually, I
tip it up, brother.
Let's see what it is.
This guy's a triple threat. That's short, fat, and ugly. He's been wondering since the sixth grade, how come chicks just don't want to fuck me? It's because you're a loser. You getting laid is the definition of lucky. And if you've ever found a girl that's drunk enough, I bet you come 3 seconds into some intercourse. He's a pre-ejaculator. A guy who needs to practice on his raps, come back, and later you can try me when I'm belligerent. I won't lie, you're insignificant. And that huge-ass ego trip ain't gonna compensate for that little dick. This guy's a little kid, and I can't be raping babies, even if this ape with rabies is basically just a lady. You're a custom case of crazy if you think you could be beating me. I suggest you walk on home, watch Will and Grace, and beat your meat. Cause that's the only time you'll feel complete. This dude's so whack, he steals his beats. And still he can't find a single person ever who wants to hear him speak.
Way easier than I thought.
Yo, perhaps you didn't hear my last verse.
Nope.
Cause you got fucking murked. And battling me is something you do not deserve. I'd like to introduce y'all to the first rapping black smurf. Yo, and this whiny prick makes me sick. When it comes to life, he seems confused as shit. I'm sure he's got the itch. I'm just curious. Do you receive or do you pitch? Yo, and I tried digging up dirt on this dude. Heard the same drunken stories, nothing new. But I've got news. This chump blew chunks in his last battle against you know who.
And I want it too.
Me and this guy, yeah, we're about the same height. But I bet I'd fuck him up in a fist fight. My style's unique. Your style's just weak. Sounds like a broken record every time you speak. An abstract, that's a played out name. You'll probably go hang yourself after I beat you today. Look a biter on Wikipedia, you'll probably see his face. And when it comes to this rap shit, you're a fucking disgrace.
Nice. Pretty clever.
Those were some good words that rhyme.
You got a foul for talking.
I got a foul for talking?
That's what it is.
Oh man, I didn't even know about all that stuff.
Go.
Oh well, I'm pretty sure I won it anyway.
So we already knew this was going to be a battle of the races. But the fact that you're a racist doesn't really even make sense. You act as if trying to be black is part of your day shift, but at night you act more white because you're back in your parents' basement. So face it, which one of these assholes drove you here? They should have been a better bro and told you you're a hopeless queer. Drove you back to Michigan, filled you up with coke and beer, and said you'd have a better career at letting people poke your rear. but let's not focus here. This is about who can rhyme the best. Not which one of us has jerked off more times to Aunt Jemima's breasts. Last time I was up here, I wasn't even a finalist, but you trying to take credit for Mantra's win makes you a spineless bitch. So now he's kind of pissed, which will probably get him flustered, and he's gonna come back with some attack summed up as crap with a bunch of cuss words. But let me break the news to you all, getting all the strength that you can muster. You want it on the scene as much as a herpes-infested cluster.
Give it up for the battle, y'all! Judges have to say.
It was very close, y'all. Very close. Homie, you need to stick with it because you was like right fucking there, dude. Like, you did good. First rounds were strong. I'm going with him, though, right here.
Yeah.
Abstract. Yeah, I
got to
get him to abstract. Also, 2 rounds to 1. If he finished stronger and hung in there, he probably would have got it.
Dude, yes.
Right over here to the left. Guys made it kind of hard for me, which is a good thing. Both of you had polished shit, but I think Abstract got a little bit more in there.
Ooh!